sex addiction. Is it real, or is it an excuse for someone who wants to just be irresponsible? Senior medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen has been looking into this, and she actually found a guy who is a, and most people wouldn't go on record and say this about themselves, this guy's a self-described self-addict, right?
Oh, yeah. He says he's a sex addict. He wants his identity hidden. You'll see that when you hear from him, because it would ruin his, he says it would ruin his life if people knew it. But his wife knows, his kids know, and he says that it was a real addiction. It wasn't just like he wanted to cheat on his wife, but he cheated with a lot of women. So shall we hear the first one?
Let's go.
All right, let's hear from him.
In your first 20 years of marriage, how many women did you have affairs with?
I think it's around 30 to 35.
And then there were prostitutes in addition?
Yeah.
And then there was pornography in addition?
Yeah.
Why couldn't you be faithful?
Yeah, I tried to be. I tried. You're just completely powerless against this thing that takes you over, whether you want to call it an addiction or a disorder, whatever label you want to put on it. There's no choice.
How did you feel if you didn't have sex? How would that make you feel?
You know, you get the shakes. It's really a classic case where you need the drug.
Is it like meth or heroin?
There's a lot of parallels, at least in terms of the chemistry. You need a hit, right? And you want to attain that hit for as long as you can.
What was the longest you could go without the need to have an orgasm?
You know, probably a day or two, a couple days. And then, you know, on that third day, you just go crazy.
Now, here's the question. Okay. He says he's a sex addict, and it sounds impressive, but the American Psychiatric Association says no such thing as sex addiction.
Right, the DSM-4, which is sort of the Bible for psychiatrists that lists all the diagnoses, does not have sex addiction
right.
as an actual disorder. But I'll tell you, I talked to many psychiatrists who believe that it really is, and when they bill it as impulsive behavior or something else.
Well, yeah, but anybody can have a compulsion. I mean, I bite my nails. You know, some people can't stop going to the refrigerator for 2 minutes. Everybody has something. This guy's thing is that. But the idea of creating a disease and calling it something for a guy, I'd like to rob every bank I see because I'd like to have all the money in the world. But I don't because I know I shouldn't.
Right.
But I respect my wife. And you know, that's just the way I am.
Right.
I could go cheat on her every day and I would call it an addiction.
Right, but what psychiatrists would say is if you are doing something that is a problem in your life and you can't stop it, you're an addict. So this is a guy whose children, his teenage children, found his stash of video porn and he was horrified, but he kept doing it. This is a guy who woke up at 4 a.m. to watch 3 hours of porno before his wife woke up.
Jeez.
And he said he wanted to stop, he wanted to stop, he wanted to stop, and he couldn't. And
What's he doing now?
He's working. He has been through a treatment program similar to the one that Woods is said to have attended, and he has gotten beyond his addiction. It took him a lot of work, but he did. But he said, what was interesting to me is that he said it wasn't fun. It just got to this point where he was like a meth addict taking meth, and he didn't actually enjoy it. So let's listen to what he had to say about that.
Yeah, let's do.
Some people will say, wow, what a guy. He managed to meet women in elevators and have sex with them.
Yep.
And what would you say?
It wasn't fun at all. It's just not a good time. When you get to that point, you've already tried to quit. You've already tried to modulate your behavior, to control aspects of it. Your life is completely out of control.
A lot of guys just have affairs, but they're not sex addicts. How do you separate the two?
For me, there's a physical aspect to the withdrawal. If you're going to orgasm 5 or 6 times a day, you're flooding your brain with a lot of chemicals. It's pretty powerful.
What?
Yeah.
Flooding your brain with a lot of chemicals? Is that what he said?
That's what he's saying. He's saying that when you need to have that feeling 5 or 6 times a day, it starts to run your life and it floods your brain with chemicals. Now, I did talk to psychiatrists who said there's no such thing as sex addiction, but they do agree that someone like this, if it's not addiction, maybe it's an obsession or a compulsion, and they do need professional help. So even the shrinks who don't think it's an addiction say people like him need professional help.
I think we could both certainly agree it can also be used as a likely excuse.
Yes.
And which is what, by the way, you probably don't listen to sports talk as much as I do, but if you get on any radio in America and drive down the highways and byways, you'll hear sports guys one after another and every caller saying that Tiger Woods is using this as an excuse.
Well, you know, it's
for his irresponsible behavior.
Well, I don't think Tiger Woods has actually said that he's had a sex addiction.
Well,
right?
He's in a clinic.
Right.
He's in a rehab clinic.
Well, I mean, we don't know the fact.
What else would he be there for?
When I ask psychiatrists who believe in sex addiction, do you think Tiger Woods was a sex addict based on what you've read in the media? They said, look, we don't know enough details. If he is seeing woman after woman after after woman and going to look at pornography, that tells you something. If it's sort of an affair here and there, that's different. It's the need to have constant affairs and to watch pornography. This guy was having sex all day and then going to look at pornography.
Your point's a good one, because when I looked this up, knowing we were going to have this conversation, that's what it said in the American Psychiatric Association. It said, we are not going to call someone having an affair a disease,
correct,
nor should
absolutely
anybody even begin to do that.